Welcome back. This is Mo with 2+ Minutes of Fame, and today I am supporting the Embrace the Grace Cup from Pastor Bob, and it's a four-finger cup. Okay, as you can see, got all four fingers in there. It's actually a mug, I'd say, and there's quite a few. I've even got another one coming and another shirt coming in a few days. And so, hey, today I wanted to talk about puzzle pieces. Have you ever put together a puzzle? I enjoy it as long as it's like the 12 or 15 piece. Just teasing. I've put together bigger ones. What's interesting about puzzle pieces is when you're putting together a puzzle, you got to find just the right piece to go in. It's got to fit with each other. And, you know, we kind of think that the ones in the middle are the most important because it really tells most of the picture. But if you put together an entire puzzle and then at the end you're missing a piece, one piece, and it could be the corner piece or an edge piece or one down at the bottom that maybe doesn't have a lot of color to it, the puzzle is undone. It's unfinished. And you're like, even though the main part of it is beautiful and shows the picture, that one piece there will bother me. If I'm missing a piece anywhere in any of the puzzle and I'm all done, it's like, I'm not done. It's undone, and it's not complete. And I don't know about you, but you know, if I get that far on a puzzle and there's a piece missing, then it's like, well, what the heck? And so I was talking to my sister about this, and she had mentioned that we as Christians are a piece of the puzzle of God's plan. And we all have to fit in there. And if we try to force ourselves into the plan or into the picture where we don't belong, it messes it all up. And what she was talking about that was her and her husband Larry came and visited me at my church during youth night. And they both run a ministry, a men's and women's ministry. And they're all adults. And once in a while, they have a teenager that will come, but they're very quiet. They sit there very quietly and very respectful. They act like an adult. Okay. But here, these teens act like teenagers. And they had noticed how I interacted with them. And they just had said, hey, you know, we just want to tell you, that is your element. Definitely not ours. And my brother-in-law, Larry, kept saying, no way, no way. And I just feel right at home with them. And I can relate to them. And I see myself in them. And so I kind of act like them at times. And I definitely don't act my age. I do know that. But it's my piece. It's where I fit in. And I had a desire to be a senior pastor for quite some time, probably the past couple of years. And then when I went on a youth trip with them, I realized that, man, if I was a senior pastor, I wouldn't be going on things like this. I wouldn't be seen and being able to pour into their life and see the progress like you do in adults. I mean, adults, they're kind of, you know, you're pastoring, you get to see lives change, but not like this. And when I was there at a youth conference, it was a youth leadership conference. I was there for them, but yet I got a lot out of it. And one vision God showed me was you know, is kind of complaining that these guys are just not getting it. You know, what is wrong with you? Don't you get it? You know? And he reminded me that when I was their age, 13, 14, 15, I didn't get it either. I didn't actually give my heart to Jesus till I was 17. And so what he showed me in a vision was me with a 5-gallon bucket of water. And that 5-gallon bucket represented 1 year. And he showed me a 1-liter bottle or a 2-liter bottle of pop that was empty. And I picked up that 5-gallon bucket and I was pouring it from a distance, water into that 2-liter bottle, trying to hit a hole that big. And of course, most all the water went outside of it. And each 5-gallon bucket might have put that much water into that 2-liter bottle. And he said, you're going to keep pouring into these kids constantly, and very little will get in there. But there will be some things that stick with them the rest of their lives. And when it gets about half full, the light will start to turn on. It'll start to come on. And I realized that, hey, it's not about them getting it now. It's just me keep pouring in and keep pouring in. And eventually, they'll get it. And that really helped me out a lot. So the puzzle piece that you are, figure it out, number one. And number two, when you do figure it out, go where you're supposed to go. Because wherever God wants you, you're going to prosper. Other than that, have a great day.